Hello students, welcome to your social studies class. Today we came again with chapter number 3, Sharing and Caring, from your social studies book, Irish First Book, A Contemporary Approach to Social Science, book 1, page number 14. We have already done in the last class objective type questions and answers, like tick the correct answers, fill in the blanks, true and false. Now today we'll start with the subjective type question and answers from exercise D. Let's start. Answer the following questions. Number 1. Students, first you will write or jot down all the points in your copy. Jot down all the answers in your copy and then you can learn them. This will come in your exams. They are very important. So let's start. Number 1. Who look after the family? So children, we have read the chapter. What is the answer now? Our parents look after the family. So who looks after the family? Our parents look after the family. Number 2. Who earns money for the family? Father earns money for the family. Answer. Students, you will have to write the full sentence, not just who earns money for the family. You will write not just the answer like father. You will have to write the full sentence to complete the answer correctly. That will be in a correct order. So who earns money for the family? Father earns money for the family. See, I have also completed the statement or sentence for the answer. Number 3. What work does a mother do? Mother looks after the house and cooks food. We all read that mothers, what does mother do? Mother looks after the house and cooks food for us, isn't it? Cooks food for the family members and us. Some mothers go to work too. So the mothers who stay at house, what are they called? Housewives. And the mothers who go for work outside, they are called working women. So the answer is, let's revise again. Mother looks after the house and cooks food. Some mothers go to work too. Let's come to number 4. Whom should we always obey? Now students, whom should we always obey? We should always obey our parents. So we should always obey our parents, respect them, and then we should always listen to them. Whatever they say us, we should always listen to their instructions and obey them. Now number 5. In what ways should children help their parents? Write any 3 ways. So students, you need to write 3 ways how we children should help our parents. Okay, so what are they? Let's come to the answer. So any 3 ways children should help their parents are as follows. Any 3 ways children should help their parents are as follows. They are, number 1, children should help their mother in the kitchen. So we children can help our mothers in the kitchen. Number 2, they should take care of the guest. When guests come inside our house, we can take care of them. We can ask, we can greet them first. We can open doors for them to enter the house. We can then ask water or something to make them feel comfortable. Okay, so they should take care of the guest. Who are they? Children. Okay. Number 3. They should keep their room neat and clean. What children should do? Children should keep their rooms neat and clean. Next, this is the last answer. Number 6. When do parents feel happy? So when do parents feel happy, students? Parents feel happy when the children help them. So parents feel happy when children help them. when their children help their parents, so parents feel very happy. Okay, so these are the answers that we need to learn today. First, write, jot it down in your copies, and then say and write, and then learn all the answers. This will come in your exams. Okay, students, these are subjective type question and answers. We have done objective type question and answers in the last video, and this is subjective type question and answers. So learn them, understand them, say and write, learn, revise and practice. Okay, students, this is the task for today. Thank you. Take care. Now, students, we have another exercise from the same page, page 14, Think Tank. How do children share the work at their home? So there are four pictures. Now you'll have to take the correct one, the work in the given pictures. How children are working and helping their parents at home. Next, just below that, we have creative activities. That is exercise number E. There are different occasions on which families celebrate together the joy and happiness. Birthday of any family member is one of them. Write to wish your father and mother. So, if you have your book, you can do this exercise, like paste your father's picture on the left side and paste your photo on the right side. And then you can write some lines for your father. The next is same similarly for your mother. Paste your photo here and then paste your mother's photo on the right side and some lines in the middle. You can write for your mom. Next, on page number 15, exercise F. Ask your parents about your relatives, that is grandparents, uncle, aunts and cousins. Then fill in appropriate information. So number 1, you will write your grandfather's name. Number 2, grandmother's name on the right hand side. Number 3, uncle's or uncle name. Number 4, aunt's or aunt name. Number 5, cousin's name, like daughter of your uncle and aunt. Okay, next we come to exercise G. If you have your book, you can again do this. Prepare a chart using the following instruction. Number 1, write down various works done by your father. You will take help of your parents and then write some points of various works done by your father. Next, number 2, write down the names of the household activities done by your mother. Mummy or papa, dono ka kaam aapko likhna hai, point wise. Okay, here on these clouds, on the blanks, you can write 4 points for your father and 4 works done by your mother. Next, in the bottom, come to the bottom, see there in the yellow box, you can see life skills. Tick what you do. Aap kya kaam karte ho ghar mein, wo aapko likhna hai, usme se tick karna hai. To the correct option. So you'll have to write whether number 1, pack your bag for school. Kya aap apne bag pack karte ho school jaane se pehle? Number 2, can you polish your shoes? Number 3, put away toys after playing. Matlab aap apne toys sare apne jagah pe rakh dete ho, apna shoe polish karte ho ya apna bag pack karte ho. Whatever you do, you will tick the correct option. This is the task you will have to do. Okay, students, bye bye, take care.